dizer o take care. Classes, radio calls, engineering course. Because I did, I know some of us do not have to try. But when you look at the volume of road crashes on our road, it's alarming and it's killing. So some of us do not have to try. But we must call it a road transportation or something that makes driving to the world interesting and enjoyable. Now we're going to divide this class today. And you give in A and B. So how many A do you have? Your hands up. It's a class, so it's a class. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. B, let me see your hands up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should be 5 now. Be 5. You are B at time. So it's going to be a class. And we are going to test ourselves on different kinds of exams. Sometimes it could be vocal, we have to determine. So one person will represent group A. So if I test you and you, we will know who wins. You and you know who wins, and the other person has to. So let's start by saying, we all know what driving is all about. And what is driving? To go back, who can tell me what driving is all about? What is driving? Okay, driving is moving a car. It's a car you want to move. Straight. Do you understand? Now, where is the first point of challenge now, if you want to look at it, we are talking of card blue. The first part of challenge, where is it coming from?
First one on the left.
First one by your
left. Left.
No.
By your right.
By your right.
Oh, right.
And what do you call this? The person coming from here now. To you, Abby?
Yes, sir.
You have an interest to go through, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
And this person have an interest to go like this. Hello? And the government built the road for what?
Everybody.
Either I have a power bike, because they're there, right? Let's assume that I'm the one that is coming from here now, and I want to connect to this road. I'm going to Chevron. Maybe I want to go and prove. Do you get my point? And Aladia is here. You are going to Idumata, you want to go and buy your goods, right? In as much that your car is licensed by law, you have your vehicle papers, and my Okada, no matter how rickety it is, in as much it can move on the road by law, I am permitted to do what? To be on the road. So I have an interest, you have an interest. So the first point of challenge to car B now is what?
The green.
The green stuff. And the first point of challenge of green is what?
The blue car.
The blue car. Are we getting the point now?
Yes.
Listen, out of 100% of road crashes, 95%. How many percent?
95%.
So look at the ratio at this left. 95% happen at what? At T junctions. Scarcely will you see road crashes happen on expressway. And when it happens, what has contributed to that? What caused that?
Overspeeding.
Over what?
Overspeeding.
And you know, we have said that several times, that overspeeding kills faster than what? Than even Ebola. I don't know how many number has officially been confirmed that Boko Haram has killed since they started their wala. It's 30,000, have you? But I want to think that we have had close to times five of that compared to road accident. As it be reported, how many volume have you had? Of course, I have talked to right now an accident has happened. Somebody is either dead or what? Or injured. So moving your car from point A to point B, you are going to have challenges. Now, excuse me, this challenge here. What do you call this challenge? The challenge between here and here. What do you call it? We call it vehicular challenge. Because it's a challenge between car and car. Are you getting my point? So, class, what do you do when you get to this kind of environment? And do what? Okay. Good. I want your language.
Slow down.
Good. All those things, you are still doing the same thing. What I will call, when you are walking, you don't keep your arms like this, do you? You must stretch it out so that you'll be free. If somebody walking like this, look at this between. The movement will not be sweet. You get my point? You negotiate. What do I say?
Negotiate.
You negotiate. There must be negotiation between the two of you. Just like when you are doing business, when you came here, I didn't do price. Is that true? So there must be a kind of negotiation between the two of you here. And by the law of road, who owns the road here? That's where the two of you will collide. The two of you will collide. The two of you will collide. And the two of you will collide. So who is A? Who is B? Okay. Mr. A, you are on the left-hand side, which is what? Your car is what?
Blue.
Good. And you are green.
Green.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. You know your position on the road now. Please, who owns the road here now? Who should go first?
The man on blue.
The man on blue. Yeah. Who is the man on blue?
A.
Okay, yeah. Your argument. Why will you go first?
I think the road is straight. I'm trying to go inside the road. I have to wait for him first.
To go straight. Okay, you have to wait for him. Okay, let's get this right now. Where's your car? Your car is green, I mean.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
the thing is going straight. I have to wait for it because right now it is the wrong road.
Do you have any objection?
Yes.
So you say objection?
Yeah.
Hold on. You say objection.
Objection.
But when they say what is not right, tell them objection, right? Eh? Oh yeah, objection granted. Mm-hmm.
The man on me. Because the first person at the junction.
Okay.
For the man on.
Okay. I have objection.
Objection.
Okay, you want what?
And B.
B? Yes, sir. So you want to object what he said, I did?
Yes,
so what he said is not right.
It's really right, I want to add to it.
Huh?
It's right, I want to add to it.
You want to add to it? Yes. Okay, go ahead.
The man on blue should go first so that there will be chance for the man on green to come over.
Okay. Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
The man on blue.
Sit down. It's another class. Mm.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
The man of view should go first because he's seen the road due. And the man on green is not already having access to the road. He doesn't know what is happening on the road first. He should wait and watch first before he goes out to the road. Because that man on blue is not seeing him coming out. He might be on speed.
Okay.
So the man on blue has a free access to the road first.
Okay. Everybody, open to it. A neutral page, where there is no anything. Just give me an answer. Give me one. Because, see, we here, we will not compromise on that for anything. We have option to just push on the road and teach you Jack. See my point?
Yes.
But what we keep saying is that when we teach you Jack, my daughter, my son, my mom will be the immediate victim of the jack I've taught you. So the eradication of either corruption, we have corruption in driving as well. You understand? But when you don't drive right on the road, you're a corrupt person, you're a corrupt driver, and your epidemic spreads. So the antidote to correct bad driving on the road, we will start from here. So we are not going to care about how much pain is going to cost us or how much time is going to cost. We will do it right. Do you understand? Are you there? You are here. Okay. Question number one. No sign. Give the meaning of this. And the question came out from what we have here. It is this katakata that brought about that. And I said it before. I said, out of 100% of road accidents, 95% happen at what? So I'll give you an expo. Are you getting my point? So this place is a T junction now, Abby. But when you look at it, somebody is coming for here, somebody is going like that. Abby, the two of them, somebody want to go like this, somebody want to go like this. Am I right? Uh-huh. So what is the meaning of this? Are we done? We are done. I've written something. Let me see your hands up. I've not written anything. Let me see your hands up. 1, 2. Order. Take a stand. Have you written something? You never had anything. I talk now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Have you? The problem about that, we don't write. What is this? We don't know it, have you?
Yes, sir.
We don't know it. Good. And that is why we have come to driving school. Okay, good. I don't feel embarrassed about that. We are all learning. You understand? Okay, I've written something. Let me see your hands up. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I've been. Okay, A. B, I've been. A. You didn't write anything. Why did you write it? Fighting this part. Okay, what is the answer there?
T-junction.
Okay. T-junction, but it is not. It is T-junction, right? But there is something I expect you to add to it. In this case now, who owns the right of way? The person going straight. Substantiate that.
Sit down. One of the reasons why I think so is, let's assume we are using the blue and the green car, right?
Yes.
First of all, the time it will take for the bring her to come out of the T junction.
Okay.
It's more than the time it will take for the blue car to pass through.
Okay.
That's one.
Okay.
Secondly, there's something called right of way, right?
Okay.
You should always give right to someone who's always at the left.
At the left. This left clap for her. Okay. Any further argument? Okay. Now, did anybody give contrary answer to this?
I said intersection ahead.
Intersection. Okay. You are right, and if you say T Josh Maxwell, you are equally right. But here, this is the arithmetic of this now. It means that the way this rule is being structured, the sign here is called what? How many road signs do we have anyway? How many road signs do we have? Three. Good. Elijah said three. What any? Give us an idea. This is the common belief that we have three types of road signs, but it is actually four. How many did I say?
Four.
It's not three. It is four. Right? And one of them is called, what category of road sign does one belong to? Warning sign or danger sign. Of all the road signs, this one is the most vulnerable one. This one is the one that if you don't obey this one, it leads to death. As a matter of fact, we have four types of road signs. How many? We have the danger sign. We have the regulatory. And in this regulation now, we have two types. Under regulation, we have what? Two types. Mainly, there's one that is prohibitory. Of course, you know, when they say something is prohibitory, it means what? Don't. And there's one that's called mandatory. And you know the meaning of mandatory, meaning what? You must. And the last one is what? Informative signs. Informative signs give you direction of where you are going to. If you get to Lekki Phase 1 now, you will see the road signs over there. If it tells you this way to Lekki Phase 1, it's always in what? In green. So, and you have the danger sign is always in red. That's why this man said red or danger. That's why it's gap. All those ones over there, they are called regulatory, okay, danger signs. Please, any of them that you refuse to obey, there's likelihood of 50% it will lead to what? An accident. So, if you have this, and you have a child driven inside, meaning what? Somebody is drawn inside there. Somebody inside that truck. It's what? Zebra crossing or children crossing. Right? Sorry. Zebra crossing means, this is it?
White lane.
White lane, right? Meaning that if Mr. A has stepped, please give me attention. If Mr. A has stepped on one of these lanes and he steps here, you that your car is here, please, he said you must stop. And if you now unconsciously, maybe you weren't looking very well when the man crossed the road, please, thou shalt not touch the anointed servant or the son of Jonathan. If you hit anybody on this line and the person died, you will die as well. They will kill you because it's a murder case. Because the road signs have been given to you. You didn't look at the road signs. Now, the person that the road sign is protecting, you now kill the person ignorantly. You go for it. You understand? Of all the danger signs, this one is very, very important. You must know it because you have this one in major places. And where we have all these ones? Where you have schools, marketplaces, hospitals. Where people use like maybe highly residential environment. Is that understood? And if there's animal inside, what does that mean? That means animals are in that kind of environment. Your speech world should be limited. All these things are given so that we'll reduce our speed at a particular point of a time. Is that given? If you have this one, regulatory ones. I've told you we have the prohibitory and we have the what? The mandatory. If you have something like this, and you have 80, meaning what? That you must not exceed this. Let's get something right here. On this, our express road here, the speed limit is what? Who knows?
50.
It's 50. But how many of us drive 50? Even if you drive 50 there, fuck will kill you. Because you'll be too slow. And that is what the government said we should do. Everybody drive 80, 100, or even when you do 120. Even when they get to Aja, like bus stops here, they still do that. The one of regulatory, you see something inside here. They put something like arrow. Meaning what?
Two ways.
Do you understand? That means you can drive either towards here or drive towards here. Is that understood? So make it how many now? Make it how many have I discussed? Three. We have discussed three. And the last one is what? The informative one. Please make it what? Four. So how many road signs do we have, class?
Four.
We have four types of road signs, not three. We have danger signs, we have regulatory signs, and under regulatory we have the mandatory and what? And the prohibitory. The mandatory, you must do what the road sign says you must do. E.g., you have something like this arrow, so that what? That is the right hand side you can go. Is that understood? You cannot go to the left. If you go to the left, what are you doing? You are driving against what? Wrong way. Mind it's not one way. Call it. It's a wrong way. Right? Okay. Let's go ahead. So the little bit. We drive. I'm having challenge with my driving. Let me see your hands up. Money should know for the vision one or two. Take a while back. Oh, yeah, every round questions. The challenge we are having for handling your driving, let's treat it. Okay, you don't have my torch, right? Okay, is that all? Okay, your jack this time is okay now, right? Okay, this is your clutch, right? And what?
Trotty.
So you give me 100%. It's 100, and this is what? Zero. And this is 100, and this is what? And this is 100, and this is what? So let's take it like this. This is Mr. What? Am I right? Our knowledge says that when you want to move your car, let's have that. This is your Gia. And what? So my gear is here now. It's in Paris. Right? You want to drive the car from there? I mean, this have you done, sir? Your first day? Fourth day? Okay, sir. I am the one that driven the car and I'm parking the car in Jawan and I'm giving the car key. Right? So drive the car from there. What will you do? How will you drive the car? Yes, now you want to drive the car.
I'll close down and remove the gear from the crowd.
Why will you do that?
So I have to be sure that the car is on the road. So I have to be sure that the car will not move immediately as I start the car.
Okay, clap for yourself. So you are right, right? The first thing you should do is what? You have to prepare the clutch and fit the car back to what? Neutral. You understand? And when you have done that, definitely the clutch has to come up, right? Okay, go ahead.
Okay. I will then start the car.
Okay.
Then if I start the car, I will clutch better.
Good.
Then let's take the total. Yeah, the rate of the 20.
Good. 20%, right?
Yes,
okay, hold on. It's 20%. If you take it good, 20%. What kind of sound will it give you?
If you give me a sound that makes a noise.
Okay. How would you describe the noise? Is it really normal or abnormal?
The abnormal noise.
Huh?
Abnormal.
Yes. Is it right?
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. When the clutch is down, when the car is normal, you give an abnormal noise because.
When was coming in?
When the car is still,
okay.
It will give an abnormal noise. But if I release my leg from the throttle or from the clutch to 40, when it starts moving, it will be giving a normal noise.
And you got it right, and that you are missing one of the people. So who can say it better? Can I say it better? You start afresh? Okay, from where it is. Okay, let me take you back. Hold on. I think we all know where I am now. You know where I am? Where I am?
That
will be neutral. Okay, good. Okay, so what happened there?
So, now you can connect it. Take the gear to the one. 3:37. You get in the
car. Thank you. You get that? Yeah? Always remember. You have to listen to your engine, right? That's why some of us, we have the issues. We don't listen to our engine. We just put our leg on the touch over there, we think it's a groove. Always listen to your engine. You know, the engine will do two things, huh? It's either it grinds, have it, or do what? Good. So go ahead.
Can you believe your
40%. Now, let's get this in right. I clutched down 20%. I mean, I felt my total 20%. I felt the total 40%. Right? You know, this one will give me anything what? And this one will give me anything what?
Yeah.
Good. Now, if my engine is giving an engine drive, excuse me, you have to romantically take the clutch off. Now, the amount you need over here, maybe 10%, the car will move. Do you get my point? And at the point of leaving your leg from the clutch, it shouldn't be your leg that will running away from the clutch. It is the clutch that wants to be doing like this. The clutch will be pushing your leg. Not you taking your leg, I'm off. Once you do that, that's what most of you do. You say, I'm off. And once you're off, what the engine will do? The engine too will off. But if your leg, if the clutch push your leg up, you will feel it. The car will just go like that. Is that taken? But if in reverse, you happen to do 40%, which will happen sometimes, right? Especially when you are taking in the morning, some of you do that mistake. You have taken a lot of apple. There's still much power in your body, and you have taken a lot of energy. So if you are going to press 40%, is that taken? No. Okay, Pastor, what I said is that, no, I made a mistake here. Let me do the correction. If it's 20% to flex, please, sometimes the flush must come to what? 40% before you count. But if it happened to be 40 to flex, just me at 10 will be enough. Do you know why? Who can explain that?
Because of the speed of the
food or the supply, of what you have put inside the engine. Chicken and point. If you have been in a journey now for close to what 2 or 3 hours and we have been jogging, you know your system and normal system. And we now go to a place where they want to offer up water. The amount of water you take will not be the same time for the same, because of what our system. So what you have put inside the engine at present, you have changed the amount of food or energy you have put inside the car. Is that taken? So that determines how you take this one up, right? Ah, okay, so let's continue from there. You have taken your clutch off, have you? Okay, and that means your car is what? Okay, good. So let's look at it. The car is what? Because your car will either do any of this at a time. It's either you move the car, right? Or you stop the car, or you do what? You slow down the car. It must be either or before you're going to do. It's like you park the car, you move the car backward, or you slow down the car, you stop the car, or you move forward. It's not the phone. So your car is moving now. We are still continuing. Okay, stop the car. Oh, you have hit somebody. Hold on. I said stop the car now. That's right. It's driving. And you know that as they happen, how many hours? So me, I say stop the car now. That's right. If you enter the car now, and you are saying thinking, or you are saying. Like one of our students, who was inside the car with that? Oh, Jesus, I love you. And the car is going. Hey, thank you so much for that. When you guys